Hey everybody, it's David here, and today we're gonna be designing UI buttons for a game. There are a few nuances that separate just a flat application design UI and a game UI. So let's begin. So the first thing that we need to do is to define our base shape. Okay, let's do it. Let's make a rectangle. Okay, now let's have no stroke, but just the base color. Let's begin with orange. Orange is a nice color for a button. Very pulls your eye to it. Orange is a very strong color. It wants some action. And this is a button, therefore there's gonna be some action. Let's add some radius to this button. Oh yeah, and I'm doing it in Photoshop because I'm just used to working in Photoshop. And Photoshop has really evolved in terms of its capabilities, its vectorial capabilities. This radius thing, Illustrator had it like 20 years ago. But Photoshop is just recently added it, like an year ago or something. It really it was really nice addition to Photoshop. So we have our radius. Let's have some roundness to it. Okay, so let's go to transform tool with Control T. Let's do warp, and in the warp where it says custom, we're gonna choose inflate, and we're just gonna inflate it just a tiny bit, like this, just a tiny bit more. Yeah, now we ruined our shape, but it's okay. We have this fun aspect to this button. It's not just a rectangle with the radius corners. It has some kind of fun aspect to it, even though it's just a simple shape. So the first thing that we need is gradient overlay, and we will pick a color from the orange family, like some reddish color to it, something like this, and it already becomes more interesting. Okay, now let's add some more elements to this button. For example, let's do a stroke inside with a big size. Okay, and instead of color, let's do gradient maybe, and in this gradient we can do also colors that are similar to our base color, something like this. Now let's add some glossiness to it, and this we can do by inner shadow. We can just do a normal inner shadow with a very bright color. We could also do this by creating another rectangle with rounded corners with simple white color and on opacity. Maybe not white, maybe it should be yellowish, like this. And here on the base color as well, I think we should make it more yellow, like this. Begins to look like something. Now we can add a little mask over here, over the stop area of this highlight. And of course we could also do the same warp inflation that we did to our basic shape, to the base shape. We can do just, you know, some kind of mask on the sides as well, so that it also blends well on the sides. We could also use some highlights, okay? And again, with shapes, white shapes, for the highlights. And of course, because we have these highlights on the left side, we're gonna have some highlights on the right side, on the bottom part of the button, but they're gonna be yellowish and with some opacity. It's like candy or something like this, right? Eventually, this is what we want people to feel, that it's fun and playful, and everybody wants to push this button, especially if it pays. So for example, a button in your store, in your game store, should be something that your players will want to click. You want it to look like something that they want to click on. They want to experience the touch. Okay. So here I added just another stroke layer in this layer style. And I'm just playing with it a bit to make some kind of depth to the button. And we also can add another one just like this, but on top of everything, highlighting the top part and darkening the bottom, just like that. And it really should be just a hint, just a tiny, tiny hint. We could also do bevel on this button, if we even need it. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. It really depends on the situation. Playing around with its parameters. Shadow. Maybe we could do shadow, but it can't be black. It should be also in the whorls of the warm color, like red. Something like this. Starts to look really nice. What we could do in addition is to make some inner shadow. Okay, so let's go back to our layers, do an inner shadow, but instead of white, just another highlight that basically it's all looks pretty interesting. Maybe like this. Oh yeah, looks fine to me, but I do want to add inner shadow that is more of a shadow and comes from the bottom part of the screen. Something like this. Also, of course, in the world of red colors, because we are doing an orange button. So we have this, we've done that. What we also can do is make another gradient over overlay, but do a radial style, bright color. Like this, too bright, and angle it a bit. Okay, the hardest part is to center it by eye. Good, it looks really, really nice. What I like to do personally is make this highlight not too sharp and not too mechanic. So what I sometimes do is I just flatten it, then I go to my blur tool and I add some blur to the sides of this highlight. Sometimes just give it a little bit in the center as well. Now to this other highlights that we have. So let's add an outer glow or drop shadow, whatever works for you. You could use the drop shadow as a highlight, actually, as a glow. The same we can do for this little shine over there, and maybe just a little glow to this other side of the button, the bottom side. You can see we have basically all the shapes, right? So this we can call just button base. We can do some handmade highlights now to make it even prettier, okay? So let's begin by having some kind of highlight on the stroke of this button. Yes, with full opacity. Something like this. Don't worry about it going out of the borders of the button. Of course, play with the opacity of this layer. Eventually, you want it to be pretty. You know, don't overkill it. Sometimes less is more, but sometimes it's not. Especially in games. Another highlight on this side. And you see how suddenly it just pops out even more. Maybe we could add some kind of glow here as well. And I just copied the highlight that we did. It's like basically this white glow is reflected into the button, and how would it look if it was something from the real world? So I imagine something like this. Okay, we can change the color of the background as well so that it suits our button. Okay, bluish colors work good with orange. What we didn't do, because we had white background, was to create some kind of shadow or a glow, or both, with the drop shadow layer style. It could be really just maybe even like a underglow or something. And the same we're gonna do from above, but with brighter yellow color and with really, really light opacity. Okay. Now let's have some text on it. You know what? Let's, instead of okay, let's make it really like what we said previously, purchase button. You know, I think we are missing a tiny bit of handmade touches. Let's do a particle shine. It's basically creating two stripes, then with some kind of center glow like this, and combining it together. Now we have this star shine, and we can just play with it and place it on some parts of our button. Maybe we could, you know, add some texture on the background here. And now for this we could do some kind of blending mode, even though it's not necessary, but let's try to play with it a bit. We can also add some kind of mask to it on the upper side when we have this highlight. And there you go. Simple yet fine button for your game. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope even more that you learned something from my process, how I do stuff like that. Please leave a comment below. If it was beneficial, just let me know. Until the next time, take care. Bye bye.